So appendicitis is one of the most common reasons why a pediatric surgeon gets called to the emergency department to see an otherwise healthy child. Appendicitis usually looks like, first, kind of a vague stomach ache where a child may feel a little bit unwell. They may feel a little nauseous. They may be running a little bit of a fever, but commonly they may otherwise look okay. It's hard to pinpoint where it hurts. Most kids are going to point to somewhere around their belly button at first because the pain has not, quote, localized. This is particularly tough in younger children who have a harder time articulating that they're having pain or where that pain is located. The child who's complaining of vague abdominal pain, particularly if there isn't anybody else sick in the home, certainly is something that the appendicitis should be considered. If it's severe, if a child can't or won't eat, or if they're throwing up, something I would think about even more strongly. Appendicitis comes in two basic flavors. You can have an uncomplicated appendicitis where the appendix is inflamed. We recognize it at that point. We typically can take care of that, which usually means a surgical procedure to remove the appendix. If the initial symptoms aren't recognized or progresses particularly quickly, which can happen more commonly in younger children for the reasons we've discussed, then the appendix can build up so much pressure that it bursts. In some cases, this may cause a lot of contamination of the whole belly cavity and make patients really sick. And that's what many of us think of when we think of a burst appendix. So patients who have an appendectomy for a burst appendix, whether or not that appendix has been making the child really sick, are typically here in the hospital with us longer. They're going to stay on IV antibiotics throughout the time that they're here, and stays of anywhere from a few days to a week or more are all in the range of normal. So unfortunately, there isn't a whole lot that you can do to prevent appendicitis. But you can recognize some of those signs earlier on and make sure that you get your child checked out if they're exhibiting any of those concerning signs.